So we come to the word which is used most often in marketing. That's called database marketing. And this is very, very important for retail lending portfolios. So database marketing flourishes in sectors having huge amounts of transactional data for millions of customers. So this includes things like financial services, telecommunications, retail. The earliest recorded definition of database marketing was in 1988, where database marketing was defined as database marketing is an interactive approach to marketing which uses the individually addressable marketing media and channels such as mail, telephone, and Salesforce to extend help to a company's target audience, to stimulate their demand, and to stay close to them by recording and keeping an electronic database memory of the customer, prospect, and all commercial contacts to help improve all future contacts and to ensure more realistic marketing. So, database marketing is a form of direct marketing using databases of customers or potential customers, so that is internal or external data, to generate personalized communications in order to promote a product or service for marketing purposes. Now, it is not specific to any mode of communication, right? It could be any which ways. You could get back to a database in many ways. So you might say, what is the distinction between direct marketing and database marketing? The difference between database marketing and direct marketing is the attention paid to the analysis of data. Database marketing emphasizes the use of statistical techniques to develop models of customer behavior, which are then used to select the customers for communications. Therefore, database marketers tend to be heavy users of data warehouses because having a greater amount of data about the customer increases the likelihood that a more accurate model can be built. So there are two types of marketing databases: customer databases and business-to-business B2B databases. Customer databases are primarily geared towards companies that sell to consumers. This is B2C databases. Business marketing databases are often more advanced in the information they can provide because business databases isn't restricted by the same privacy laws as consumer databases. This is very important. As a data analyst, you must understand that for B2B information, you might actually get more detailed information because they do not have the same privacy laws as consumer database. So, what are the fields that you expect to see in a database marketing warehouse? You expect to see name, address, transaction history, right, from internal sales or delivery systems or from lists bought from other organizations. So, if you were to get some information about telecom companies, as a bank, you buy the database from a telecom company and you are able to differentiate between BlackBerry users versus a communication plan users. Do you think, as a bank, you can create a marketing strategy which is differentiated for these two types of users? Do you think, first, that there should be a differentiated strategy for this type of users? Yes, right? So, because even amongst smartphones, BlackBerries are generally picked up by, employed people, people who are salaried and have a certain salary value, while other smartphones can be picked up by employed people as well as people with who are self-employed or etc. So, a BlackBerry plan would be for a particular targeted segment. So, your product offering can be tailor-made to any one segment that you have decided to target. What are the sources from where you can pick up databases? Typical sources of compiled lists are charity donation forms, application forms for any free product or contest, product warranty cards, subscription forms, credit application forms, online queries, login to certain websites. So if you go to a Facebook, it clearly says that all your information etc. is the property of Facebook and it can be used. And if you do not read all these terms and conditions, you may realize that you have added into their database and your information can be readily used by other companies which can purchase it from the Facebook. Some countries and some organizations give us consumers the ability to prevent an entry to or delete our name from the database marketing list. So you have a do not call list, do not disturb list, DND. You can opt for that and ensure that nobody contacts you. The growth and evolution of database marketing happened because of a few drivers. One was the changing role of direct marketing. So suddenly you realize that there's a to relationship based marketing, because people realize that to invest in a relationship proves to be much more profitable. There was a decline in the effectiveness of traditional media, mainly because of the explosion of media. So suddenly there were too many TV channels, there are too many internet sites, there are too many forums for social interaction. There was a change in the cost structure because the cost for using electronic media has reduced drastically over the decade. There's been a change in technology. A lot of things have gone online. People go and check out things offline, but often go back and shop online. Also, payment methodologies have changed. So there's a huge improvement in the security provided for credit card payment gateway, etc. So there has been also a change in the economic conditions. There has been an increased fragmentation of consumer and business markets. Generally, database marketing goes through four phases. There's the mystery list, which is like a random database marketing. You get a database and you just send out communication to all of it. Then there's a buyer database, where you buy some specific database and telecom company, and you can send out some mailers on that. There's coordinated customer communication, and then lastly, it's the integrated marketing approach or CRM approach. So, database marketing applications can be divided into marketing for existing customers, where you'll have a lot more of transactional information, and if you have managed to integrate your data such as to get a one view of the customer, then you are very fortunate. You can have very effective database marketing happening. And then you can have database marketing aimed at prospective customers. For marketing to existing customers, you generally would have names and addresses, transaction histories, demographics, contact history. You may also have information about personal information, so family, birthdays of children, etc. So you can use it to target a much wider range of offers to the customer. So in a credit card, if you know that a family member's birthday is coming, that in itself can prove to be a trigger for offering a database. If you know that somebody's child is getting into a certain age group where college education should start, you can send an offer for finance for education or educational loan. Then marketing to prospects relies extensively on third-party sources of data. Now, this would generally be restricted to name, address, telephone, along with demographics. And you can, but the thing is, if you would get perhaps some transaction detail related to an industry which is not your industry. So, a lot of things have to be inferred by the data compiler. So, the data compiler needs to be able to do some studies to conclude that surrogate information, can be tied back to the type of customer that we as a bank want. The data preparation for analytics and modeling or a database looks like this. You would have taken a database, say internal database of customer profile, and you could merge in some external information like your credit bureau information, the latest credit bureau information, and internal performance or transactional information. Now, why would you use the credit bureau information? We already noted that the credit bureau information includes most recent attempt to gain credit, inquiries for credit, etc. So if you know that a customer has inquired for credit in the last few days, isn't he a good target market for the product that you're looking for it, looking to market? So if you know that a customer has inquired for personal loan, it is quite appropriate to send him a mailer or some communication on the offers of personal loans that you have. So if you were to piece these pieces together, you could make a fairly comprehensive database which you can use for doing modeling and deciding two things. One is which is the type of customer you wish to target, and second is this set of customers that you are going to target, what is the probability that they will respond to your offer? So basis old data, you could come out with these two information and therefore be able to run a successful campaign. The pitfall is that some companies with large databases of customer information risk being data rich and information poor. So we know that State Bank of India has a lot of information. It has the largest consumer base in India. However, it is data rich and information poor because not enough attempt is made to mine this information. Common method of segmenting the database is recency, frequency, and monetary value, in which the customers are placed into sub-segments based on the recency of interaction with the bank, the frequency of interaction with the bank, and the monetary value of past purchases or past transactions with the bank. So you know that in banking you always have customers called high net worth individuals, etc., right? So you can often develop predictive models which forecast the propensity of a customer to behave in certain ways, most likelihood of purchase, most likelihood of large purchase, most likelihood of using his credit card for small purchases, most likelihood of using his credit card for large purchases. Then you'd also build a model that ranks these customers on their likelihood to respond to a promotion. So what are the common techniques used? You have logistic regression, which helps you do the probability piece, and then you have neural networks, which help you understand trends. So trend analysis is a huge win in this situation. Now, there have been some advances in database marketing. Using computers and CRM systems, it is possible to gain a comprehensive history of a customer's behavior on screen when he calls into your call center, etc. So this is real-time business intelligence, and this enables one-to-one marketing or personalization. So today's customer relationship management systems use the data not only for direct marketing purposes, but also to manage the complete relationship of the individual and to develop more customized products and service offerings. So with a combination of CRM, content management, and business intelligence tools, it is very much possible to make personalized information a reality and to give customers offers which are customized to their requirements. But this real-time business intelligence is a reality for only a few banks, and it could also be very division focused. So credit cards is one place where analytics is used, like in a big way. But it is not so for mortgages. Mortgages, the traditional approach still continues. Even the ERP systems often are not geared up to capture, the nuances of a mortgage loan to the lowest denominator. Because every mortgage loan can have additional documentation, can have something which is very unique to it. And those types of things have not always been captured. Also, mortgage portfolio builds up very slowly. For a bank, a credit card portfolio builds up very fast. So even to be able to leverage information of that portfolio or to build models of that portfolio, you might need information for a few years and not for a few months. There's another way to circumvent this is to do something called a proximity marketing. Proximity marketing is the localized wireless distribution of advertising content associated with a particular place. So we know that by the many acts, we are not supposed to take into account gender, ethnicity, which ethnic group do you belong to, or does the customer belong to, right? Religion, etc. But you can use a surrogate, which is the location, down to the pin code, etc., to figure out which sections of society live in which types of pin codes, and then do marketing content which is very specific to those pin codes. So transmissions will therefore be received by individuals in that location and only those who have the necessary equipment to do so. So the smartphones have a lot of features, so only people with a smartphone in a particular pin code can receive some content. Bluetooth or Wi-Fi in that area, internet-enabled device with GPS, near-field communication device, which can read an RFID chip on a product. So it can be made very localized. Therefore, location area again is one field which becomes very important in database marketing now. In the US, it's been quite some time since PIN codes have been of huge importance. In India, it's building up now. So the key takeaways of this session are the importance of marketing analytics to grow the portfolio. So we've seen that certain fields become very important and are emerging to be very important. PIN codes are working out to be surrogates of a few fields that by law we are not supposed to use. Retention databases, and then we saw the difference between marketing approaches and analytics and fields available for databases used for retention purposes for our existing customers versus databases used to target new prospects or bring in new customers.